Using Filament Free, we can actually go ahead and allow the user to select the custom theme for the admin panel. All we need to do is go ahead and compose a requires. So if we head into our application here, make sure that you have npm run dev in here as well. Let's also make sure we require this package here. So while that's running, let's go ahead and look at what else we need to do. We need to publish the assets. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so with the assets published, let's go ahead and publish to migration and then migrate it. And then outside of that, we can also publish the configuration file in here. And what we need to do as well is register this as a plugin itself. So we have into admin panel provider. Inside this provider, what we should be able to say is plugins. In this case, we're only having one plugin, so we can just add this one in. We can go in here, I'm gonna just sign in. We also want to make sure we have the middleware class set up, the set theme middleware class. Basically, we just need to go inside here where it has middleware set up, just like that. If we go in now, you can see we can then go ahead and change the theme. So we could, for example, say the Dracula theme is the one we want to go with. And then now we have the ability to basically switch between different themes, some of them which will have dark and light mode, some of them won't. But yeah, that's how we add multiple themes that the user can select in the admin panel. So the way that it works is it sets inside this migration that we just published. If we head in here, so if we add inside the add theme settings to users table, you can see that we're adding the theme and the theme color into here, which then enables us to create a custom theme, which is dependable on the user's preference instead of it being set for every user. Setting the middleware essentially just allows us to easily enable the right configuration here. You can take a more in-depth look into the package if you want to, but I just wanted to show you how to easily set up a custom theme for the user in case you were wondering how you could do that. So that's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please hit the like and the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one.